There's a dark side to coffee and chocolate, and it's not just a matter of taste. The production of both commodities has been linked to deforestation and child labor. That's why Sacramento-based startup California Cultured has made it its mission to change how both staples are made. Founded in the summer of 2020, the company's building a new lab to expand its production capabilities. Alan Perlstein is California Cultured's founder and CEO.
The process of making traditional chocolate bars versus your process is quite different. Walk us through the steps and what the difference is between the two.
Ever since cocoa was domesticated in South America, the process was that trees would take about 3 to 7 years to mature. Then about once to maybe twice a year, you have a flower, and then it takes another 5 to 7 months for it to grow. Then it has to get harvested. The beans have to get fermented. Then they get shipped. The shells get broken up and then turned into cocoa liquor. And eventually that gets squeezed into cocoa powder, cocoa butter. They get combined at different ratios to produce chocolate. What we do is we are still starting with basically a little living bean. So instead of planting it, we basically put it in a liquid environment and we trick the bean over thousands of passages to sort of grow the way that we want. So we're directly growing the tissue that basically gets turned into the chocolate.
How do you trick the bean? I've never heard of that phrase before.
So many plants usually grow in the ways that they do, usually because their next door neighbor cells basically excrete these phytonutrients that basically tell the cell what to do. And we read and developed our own process to read all of these instructions. So we sort of combine them in different ways through our media to communicate to the cell how it should grow.
Creating a new cell line, though, is a labor of love. It takes a minimum of 6 months and up to 3 years.
Once you actually have the cell line, it's roughly about a week's turnaround time for when you start the growing process to when you're harvesting basically finished cocoa. We see the future of it is if a company wants to have X hundreds of thousands of tons, they would tell us we want it to taste like this, to smell like that. We put in the right cell line, and within a couple of days later, we're able to sort of deliver a very large amount of cocoa.
At first, consumers will need to pay a premium price for the company's products. But as capacity increases, the goal is for the cost to come down. As for tasting,
we've seen about 8 out of 10 currently can't really tell the difference between what we're making and traditional chocolate.
I had to find out for myself.
Hi, welcome to the California Cultured Food Lab. I'm Steven.
Okay.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. Thank you.
Come on in.
So I met with California Culture's head of strategy and chocolate making, Steve Stearns, for a chocolate making and tasting session. Steve is no stranger to food innovation. He worked at the 3-Michelin-star restaurant, Noma, which has been named the world's best restaurant 5 times.
So Steve, you're gonna walk us through the process of creating cell-based chocolate. So
yeah.
Why don't we get started?
So the first step when we take the cells from the science team is we ferment the cells with yeasts that you might find on conventional cocoa farms. Next, we would take those cells after they're dried and we would throw them in a roaster, which is what you would typically find in a conventional chocolate making process as well. There's a lot of precursor molecules that get made during fermentation.
Okay.
Those precursor molecules combine during roasting to give you chocolatey notes. In your finished chocolate.
Mm-hmm. And what notes will be in this? What type of chocolate is it?
This one's a very fruity and cocoa forward chocolate.
Smells great.
Yeah. So you can see some of the liquid chocolate that gets ground down to a really fine size.
Next, the chocolate liqueur is poured into molds and tempered to give it a shiny look. No additives or chemicals are used through this process. For this particular batch, Steve mixed 5 ingredients, the all-important cultured cocoa powder, as well as normal cocoa powder, cocoa butter, sugar, and lecithin. Now, the moment of truth.
Well, should we taste some chocolate?
Absolutely.
All right.
Feel free to grab a bean, and I'll taste it with you. And just let it kind of melt in your mouth.
It's good. It tastes like chocolate. It tastes like chocolate that you would buy at the store. I like it. And what's the marketing plan for this once you hit the market?
We want to make the biggest impact on the chocolate supply chain that we can. And we feel the best way to do that is to try to meet the growing demand that's happening in the chocolate industry with the dwindling supply. Mm-hmm. And so we want to co-brand products with those chocolate companies.
Made with California.
Exactly.
One of those first Made With products will be a collaboration with Japanese group Meiji, owner of the popular Hello Panda snacks and one of California Culture's investors. Target market launch date sometime in 2025 or 2026. There are hurdles, of course. Bean sourcing needs to comply with anti-biopiracy laws for one. Oh, and it all still needs FDA approval for human consumption. The chocolate market is seen having an annual growth rate of 5.1% through to 2032. To help tap into that, California Cultured will need to increase production significantly and lower its price point to entice us, the consumer, to bite.